Good morning, Paul. Georgie from Allendale. It's October 17th, Monday morning, and we're starting out this week with the dollar up a little bit here, 37 points as we speak. Crude oil is about unchanged. Stocks indexes have reversed from earlier this morning. They're now trading lower at this time. The major factor this week, I think, is going to be still the macroeconomic situation in Europe, especially the Greek debt situation, the sovereign debt held by banks in Europe is going to be the biggest factor that is going to be a market mover here. The G20 meeting was held last weekend, came away with that. Trade was feeling good that, you know, there will be an answer, and believe that France and Germany will be able to work out their differences and come up with a solution, because it really is going to depend on them to get enough money put together to put toward the debt and write off some of the debt that the banks are being holding because of the Greek situation. And the G20 did endorse the idea that of the recapitalization that has been talked about last week, so that's provided some positive news here early this morning. But since that time, we've seen some profit taking, I think, and we'll probably see more of that this week as we go into the end of the week, when the deadline has been set that France and Germany need to have their decisions and a plan for the recapitalization of banks, and that will be extremely important. The test is going to be, can they get the this agreement done in time by the time G20 or the European meetings are held here later on this week. We've also got China data coming out tonight on their the economic situation there. Inflation looks like it could be up over 9% again this month, so that will be monitored very closely and could give us some reaction here tomorrow. But it's kind of a waiting game, a guessing game ahead of those things. In the fundamental picture, for directly related to agriculture, is the weather situation. The still dry in the southern plains. They definitely need more rain to keep this wheat growing and getting established before wintertime. So that is watched very closely. There is a chance of some rain here out a few more days, but still dry at the moment. South America seems to be in very good shape right now, favorable for growing crops and getting seed in the ground. This week looks like it's going to be dry in Argentina and most of Brazil, and then forecast for rain coming in late this week with 85% coverage is what the forecasts are looking for right now. In the fund situation, what kind of positions the funds have, the CFTC Commitment of Traders report on Friday showed that the funds did liquidate positions again, reduce their long positions in corn and soybeans last week, and reduce their short positions in wheat. So they're pulling money out of the markets the way it appears right now. In the livestock trade, we did have export sales last week. That was a big surprise to the pork industry, or a confirmation, I should say, to the pork industry. We've seen hogs jump sharply. The export data showed that we were ahead 43.6% above a year ago as far as the month of August go, and the which amounts to about 131 million pounds of pork that was exported, and most of that went to China, because China took 65 million pounds. That's four times more than what they normally did during the month of August. In the beef exports, good news there as well. Exports were up 28%, with Canada, Mexico, and Japan being the biggest buyers. Cutout values in pork higher again on Friday. Beef cutouts were all lower. Expect markets to start out in the livestock higher here this morning, steady to higher on follow-through buying. The grain markets, depending on the outside influences here, the strength of the dollar, we should see a steady to mixed opening there. Corn possibly 1 to 2 lower, beans 10 to 15 lower, wheat steady, and mostly on spreading there, where the last week they were buying beans, selling corn and wheat. This week we could see a little profit taking early in the week here, something to watch very closely. So if you got any questions, don't hesitate to give us a call here at Allendale at 800-262-7538. We wish everybody a very successful trading day, and we'll talk to you tomorrow morning. Thank you.